If Ralph Cifaretto hadn't died and whoever did this, what would have changed?
Fights! No fires! Tony doesn't want any fires.
How's that going?
Yeah, right.
First, let's go through Ralph's story in chapters.
You're a captain, Ralphie, when I say you're a captain.
And I'm gonna turn up my hearing aid so I don't miss.
We first meet Ralph in season 3, episode 2, Proshai Lavushka. And from the very start, Tony's annoyed with Ralph.
This was a good idea she had. I was going out to dinner. Not that I think one conversation ever solved anybody's problems.
I'm only here so I don't have to hear her bitching and crying.
He did at least try to be nice to Jackie first.
I'm putting a friend in over there as captain.
In season 3, episode 4, Employee of the Month, Tony decides to make Gigi captain over Ralph.
Fucking Gigi, are you shitting me?
My decision.
We'll get a little house. And cold snack.
Season 3, episode 6, University, is one of the most talked about episodes of The Sopranos and also one of the most controversial. Because it's this episode where Ralph kills Tracee, a 20-year-old girl who's a dancer at Bada Bing, who Ralph had been seeing and who was allegedly pregnant with his baby.
She fell.
We were just fooling around!
Just fooling around!
Look at me. I got a daughter that age.
He fell?
Making you captain.
You be the captain.
You are? That's great.
Should have let Tony chop your head off a year ago.
I love Ginny. I would never say anything like that.
Speaking of 98 pounds, I hear Ginny Sachs getting a 95-pound mole taken off her ass.
I should have let Tony chop your head off a year ago.
It'll be chopped off. Just wait.
I want you to sanction the hit on Ralph Cifaretto.
Ralph slept with Jenny?
In season 4, episode 4, The Wait, Johnny Sack asks Carmine Lupertazzi Sr., the current boss of the Lupertazzi crime family, if he can take out Ralph. And Carmine puts that down right away. He tells Johnny there are millions of dollars at stake. If he wants, he'll crack him good. He'll ask Ralph for $300,000. But whack him? Mm-mm.
We're calling it off. I'm already out here, though. Like, right there.
We'll work something out, then. Don't worry about it.
You. What did you say? Hold her back.
I'm rich! My friend at least got one!
In season 4, episode 5, Paiomai, we get introduced to the horse, Paiomai. Tony likes Pai so much that he comes down to the stables and starts going to see her by himself.
Hey, Inez! You may have some champagne.
So things seem like they're going relatively well. Especially when you think about just the prior season, where Ralph was, with University, Tracee, etc. Ralph did make a good decision in season 4 not to lend Artie $50,000.
I hate to do it, Artie. But I think I'm gonna pass. Sorry. If you don't pay me back, I ain't gonna be able to hurt you.
Oh, Tony, Valentina. Valentina, Tony Soprano.
More than likely, he had a controlling and punishing mother. She loved him, but showed it only in connection with some sort of violent or abusive act.
The bow is meant to find the ring!
This good versus bad framework with Ralph gets complicated in Whoever Did This when his son, Justin, gets pierced in the chest with an arrow. He's gravely injured, and the next time we see Justin is in a hospital bed.
Stop! Ralph, stop!
Yeah. I don't know if I'm just a sucker, but I do feel sympathetic for Ralph. To be clear, I think it takes a few rewatches before I can accept the idea of sympathizing with Ralph. But sure enough, seeing him in the hospital with his son lying in bed does the trick. And perhaps then seeing Ralph apologize to Ro, his ex-girlfriend, also has something to do with it.
It's okay. I mean, there's no way to know what it's like until it happens to you.
I haven't been in church in years. But we had a mass for Justin. It was baptism. For all the good it did.
While Justin's still in the hospital, Ralph goes to see Father in Tintola. Ralph's remark here about the baptism for all the good it did reminds me of when Polly Walnuts goes to see his priest in season 2 and says, I should have had immunity from all this shit. I should have been covered by my donations. And then with Joanne Blondetto, she blamed an 8-year-old's weight problem on his mother never having him baptized. And she talks to Christopher about this briefly in the season 4 premiere when he goes over to her house.
Would you like to make a confession?
I think I need a little more time, you know, to do a good one. But when I'm ready.
I understand.
Thank you.
All right. Well, sit down.
I just came by to give you off from the thing.
I could have waited.
At least I'm good for something. How could I let something like this happen?
Could happen to anybody, Ralph.
Indeed, Justin's hospitalization doesn't stop Tony from being Tony either. Specifically, while Ralph's literally drying his tears, Tony proceeds to tell Ralph that he and Valentina, the girl Ralph had been previously dating, are now seeing each other.
You cooked that fucking horse alive.
No, I did not! But so what? My kid's in the fucking hospital!
When Tony shows up at Ralph's house, suspecting that he's the culprit behind the fire, it appears that Ralph may finally have his gladiator moment. And again, in true Sopranos fashion, this showdown happens while he's making eggs. Someone probably should have warned Ralph to stay away from those eggs that morning.
Stop! Ralph, stop!
How it started? How it ended?
One, two, three.
So now that we've gone through this story of Ralph and his time on the show, let's think about that hypothetical. If Ralph Cifaretto hadn't died in Whoever Did This, what would have changed? Of course, anything could happen at any time. Nothing's guaranteed. So, for all we know, Ralph could have gotten into a car accident on this little highway sometime between season 4, episode 9, and the end of The Sopranos. But I'm going to think about it more from a point of view of, would Tony or someone else have ended up killing him anyway? Or would something else have happened to him related to his work in organized crime? Perhaps Johnny Sack would have tried to have Ralph taken out again. We know the more time that went on, the more trigger-happy Johnny Sack became. So how would Ralph get along with the Mafia Class of 2004? Old rats on a new ship.
Old mustache named Feach LaManna. Now, what the hell Feach meant, who the fuck knows, but...
The two new people in their crew would be Feach LaManna and Tony Blondetto. So I think about how, if at all, Ralph would impact that dynamic if he were still there. Polly was sure no fan of Ralph, and Ralph wasn't a fan of Polly either.
After you kick upstairs, you'll net...
What are you, my accountant?
I'm better with numbers than 9/10 of your accounts.
I could see that stirring up some shit.
You're late.
Well, tomorrow I can be on time, but you'll be stupid forever.
And finally, one of my absolute favorite things about Ralph Cifaretto is the actor who plays him, Joe Pantoliano, aka Joey Pants. So much so that two great friends of mine got me a cameo of Joey Pants for a birthday a couple years back. Here's a little clip of that.
What I do agree with you on is that you believe that Ralph did not kill the horse. And I believe that too. I never had that conversation with David Chase, but I just figured he was so overwhelmed with the terrible tragedy that happened to his son. And so I played it like he didn't.
Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this latest Sopranos Hypothetical. What do you think? I'd love to hear.